Olivia and welcome to my channel. So if you guys didn't know, I just finished my first year of nursing school at Boston College and I'm here to answer all of the questions that you guys have for college. If you guys have any of these questions, stay tuned for my juicy answers, but if you don't, you can comment down below with any other questions that you have and I'll either answer them in another video if there are a lot of questions or I can just answer them in the comments down below. First of all, thank you guys for your patience for this video. I know I said I was gonna post this 2 days ago. That did not happen. We're still working on my time management skills, so we'll get there eventually. Yeah, make sure to subscribe to my channel if you guys want to see more Boston College content. I still have a lot that I didn't post yet because I filmed a lot over the school year, but I never got to editing. So stay tuned for that. Actually, before I start answering these questions, I just want to remind you guys that these answers are obviously all from my perspective, so my experience can be different from someone else or can be different from your experience if you ever come to Boston College or are in Boston College. I also just finished my first year at Boston College during the pandemic, so my experience is not the normal college experience, I would say. But maybe this will help you guys get some insight into BC and what it's like and my classes and all of that stuff. Okay, so let's get straight into these questions. We have a lot to answer today. Okay, first set of questions we're gonna ask is more high school related questions. We're going to talk about my stats and extracurriculars that got me into Boston College. I really don't like answering this question and I was really hesitant about it. First of all, because I don't want to share my information. I feel like, I don't know, it's so very personal to me, but I guess it's been a year and I feel so distant from school that it doesn't matter at this point. But also, second of all, everybody has different stats and extracurriculars. I feel like it's really unhelpful, honestly. Before I get into it, basically what my school did is that we use this website called Naviance, and it basically shares the SAT / ACT scores and like the GPAs of the students from my school who got into Boston College. I feel like that gives a better ballpark because obviously admissions look at schools differently based on how rigorous they are, how many opportunities they have. So the opportunities that you have at your school may be really different from what I have at my school. And of course, college is a bunch of diverse people coming together. So not everyone is going to have the same scores. Not everyone's going to have the same interests or extracurriculars. But I guess I'll just share a little bit of mine. I don't know how helpful this is. I want to emphasize that even if your statistics and extracurriculars are so different than mine, that doesn't mean that you're not going to get into Boston College. Okay, here we go. So my GPA in high school was, I really don't want to share. Okay, my GPA in high school was 4.418 out of 5 for our weighted GPA, so it was only for our classes, and then my unweighted GPA was 3.822 out of 4. I wasn't that great of a student. I feel like definitely college I'm doing better, but in high school I wasn't that great of a student. Definitely not up there. In terms of classes, I did take 11 APs. I got 4s and 5s on them. Not the best. I kind of got 3s on 2 of them. Little embarrassed about that. That's the bane of my existence and I do not want to talk about it, but that was for US history, which was a little bad. But you know, I can say I had an excuse because my arm was broken, my right arm, my dominant arm. But I also got to type on a computer instead of write, so maybe that was better. But honestly, okay, we're just not gonna talk about that. And also for Spanish, it was during COVID and I was like a hot mess. I was so nervous. We're also not going to talk about that. I took the ACT instead of SAT because it was easier for me and I got a 35 on that. And then I took 2 SAT subject tests. I took the chemistry and math 2. So for chemistry, I got a 750. For math, I got an 800. My extracurriculars, I did do a lot of leadership. I literally have my resume in front of me, so I'm going to be checking that because I genuinely don't remember anything from last year. Okay, for leadership, I was leaders of 2 clubs in my school, a volunteer club and our school magazine. Then I was part of Academic Decathlon, which is like a academic team, I guess. And I was part of Ultimate Frisbee. I think that's basically all I did in school. I also initiated some volunteering outreach at my church that I'm really passionate about. I say like the best suggestion is just to do what you're passionate about and what you like to do. But of course, it's always good to have things that look pretty on your resume. But what's gonna make an impact on your life is what you're interested in. And one thing I think I regret about high school is really about exploring yourself. Same with college, but it's not just to write pretty things on your resume, you know. So join clubs that you're interested in, take advantage of your school's opportunities and stuff like that, because maybe the things that your college emphasizes are different than in your high school. Dabble a little. People say that consistency is also important. I don't know how true that is. I'm not in admissions. I have no idea what I'm talking about. What else did I do? I did a lot of volunteering just because that's what I like to do. But I volunteered as a teacher assistant in my town's Chinese school, where I just like taught little kids this instrument. Then I did coaching for swimming for little kids as well. And that's basically it. That was my experience. What I wrote about for my personal statement is relating to volunteering, one of my volunteering experiences, if you guys are so inclined. And I just talked about how much I love volunteering. If you guys didn't know, Boston College is very volunteer-based. I kind of forget what their motto is. Boston College emphasizes using each person's talents and using that to make an impact on the world. Yeah. So that's my stats and extracurriculars. It's out there now. Next, we're gonna talk about how my transition from high school to college was. So I think there are two parts to this question, both socially and academically. So I'll start with academically. Academically, I feel like it was about the same. Was it easier? I mean, I feel like it wasn't difficult, my transition, because my high school was pretty rigorous, and people usually say that transitioning from my high school to college is usually like pretty smooth. College is easier. I wouldn't say it's easier per se. I think my experience in high school taught me a lot, and I feel like as I grow older, I'm also like maturing more, even though I do procrastinate a lot, and because I'm taking classes that I'm more interested in, like studying. Academically, I don't think it was too challenging for me. Socially, I think, okay, so a few months before college, you know, we're imagining all these friends that we're gonna make. People say that you make your best friends in college, that they're gonna be your friends for life, and these are the people that are gonna stick with you and be your bridesmaids at your weddings, you know? And I was nervous because in middle school and high school, I just stuck with my group, and that was kind of the only little circle that I had. But in college, I honestly thought it was easier. First of all, because if you stay in the same hometown your whole life, people know you since you were little. So I feel like for me personally, if I made a big change in personality, in how I dressed or whatever, then it would be really weird because there's so much history, you know? Or if like I made friends with somebody that I knew for so long but never talked to, I felt like that was just weird because it's like, how could I be friends with somebody? We have so much history of not talking, we have history of no history. But in college, you actually start with a blank slate. You start with who you know you are, but like, obviously you can still change in college, you can still find yourself, but it's different compared to when you're little. In college, you start out more mature and then you can keep on finding yourself, but at the same time, finding friends that you have common interests with. Most of the friends I found were through clubs, not through classes. I guess that's partially because of COVID, so our classes were mostly online. Mine was mostly through religious groups because we could relate on that deeper level. I could still find more friends through classes, especially because I'm in the nursing school, as I said, so I have a set group of like 110 people that I'm always with, because we're always taking the same classes. So eventually I'll find more people in nursing that I'll be friends with, but as of now, the main group of friends I found is through church and church groups in Boston College. Okay, so now we're gonna go into talking about classes at Boston College. So the first question is, what core classes do you recommend at Boston College? So because I'm in nursing, we have like a strict structure. So last year I only had the choice of choosing 2-3 credit courses, but I chose a 6 credit course called Perspectives instead, which covers your philosophy and theology core, which are cores that you need to fulfill no matter what major you are at Boston College. I really enjoyed the class. At first I was a little skeptical about whether I would enjoy it, because I don't enjoy reading that much. I enjoy reading for fun, but reading for school and reading like people like Socrates and Plato, I was like, this is gonna be horrible. I'm not gonna understand anything, and it's just gonna be me writing papers that I don't wanna write. It was actually a really great class. I think it's really eye-opening. We have really good conversations with other classmates about philosophical things, like what is the meaning of life and stuff like that. The theology component is also, like, if you're not religious, they don't impose theology at all on you. It was reading sections of the Bible in a more analytical point of view. Not everyone was Christian in my class, and we had good discussions. For me personally, I'm a Christian, so I think Perspectives was honestly like the best thing that's ever happened to me, because for me personally, I just looked at things in a different perspective, in a different view that I never saw before. Also, one point is that I have a certain set of beliefs that I had to defend against like other people who thought differently and looked at it from a different perspective, and I thought that was really helpful for me to answer some of the questions that I had myself. I have not taken any of the other ones, so I have no idea, but Boston College actually has a Reddit page, so if you just search up Boston College Reddit page or whatever, it'll pop up on the internet, and there a lot of students ask questions about anything and everything, and then other students or anonymous people just answer them. So you can ask your own questions, you can look at what other people said. Definitely recommend doing that. The next question, who was my favorite professor? It would have to be my Perspectives professor. She was both really understanding, and she was not easy, but like you kind of understood her expectations. Her name is Katie Harster. She's a great professor. 100% would recommend. The next question is, how many hours of class did I have each day? Is it similar to high school? Is it less or is it more? Definitely a lot less. So here are my schedules for fall semester and spring semester. They're partly a little shorter because things were different because of COVID. But this is my schedule for freshman year, and my schedule for sophomore year isn't that different. It is a little different because Perspectives, we didn't have to go to class more than we did other classes, but it was a one class for 6 credits, and usually classes are for 3 credits only. So sophomore semester, I just have one more class to take. College classes, definitely not as long as high school classes. I cannot go back to 8 hours of classes every day. My schedule is probably at most 4 hours a day. That was generally my schedule. It was definitely more chill. I guess college, you feel like you have more free time, but at the same time, like, you have to study harder. I don't know. It's a give and take, you know. But I know that my friends that go to different colleges, their schedules are like jam-packed. They have classes after classes, like 8 hours, and I'm really confused how we're getting the same quality of education while they have so much class and I don't have that much class time. So I'm a little confused about that, but I think my quality of education is pretty good. The next set of questions are related to nursing specifically. So the first question is, what are the prerequisites for Boston College nursing major? I don't think there are prerequisites for any nursing major in any college, just because you obviously come from high school, so they don't expect you to go in knowing anything nursing related. To be a more appealing applicant, I'd say be good at science and math, because obviously nursing is partially interacting with people and partially also the science aspect. It's not a prerequisite, but that's probably recommended. But yeah, I took 11 APs. I didn't actually take a lot of the AP tests my senior year because Boston College, for nursing specifically, you don't take any science or math related, because you're supposed to fulfill all your science and math in the nursing core curriculum. So taking science and math don't really matter in your senior year. I'd say if you're in nursing that you should still take science and math APs if you're not in your senior year, like before you get into Boston College, because that makes you a more appealing applicant. Yeah, so basically I don't think there are any prerequisites. It's always good to volunteer at hospitals. I forgot to include that. I did a little bit of that. It's just good to dip your toes a little bit in nursing. Not that it's a prerequisite, but it's always good to kind of know what you're getting yourself into, and maybe also shows the admissions office that, you know, you really are interested in nursing and healthcare and whatever. The second question is, describe a memorable experience as a nursing major. So freshman year of nursing school, you don't actually do nursing stuff like clinicals, you don't work in simulations labs, you don't interact with patients, none of that. That's all for next year, which I'm so excited about. But as a freshman year, you just take classes. So I think my most memorable experience is probably in my anatomy and physiology lab, because I really enjoy hands-on stuff, hence nursing, not office stuff, hence nursing. Yeah, we dissected a mouse, a heart, that was kind of pretty cool, a brain, that was also pretty cool. Just doing lab is always exciting for me. So that's my most memorable experience. There's no story behind that. That's just what it is. And my last question relating to nursing is, what is your favorite freshman nursing class? Other than labs, I would say My favorite class would be anatomy and physiology because I love learning about the human body. It was so interesting learning about how all the systems work together, even though it was really difficult because it was like memorization, and a lot of studying. I really enjoyed it. It was a great class. The structure of the class wasn't that great, but the content was great. But the content was great. And the last section of questions that I have are for miscellaneous. So the question is, do you recommend buying bedding/housing stuff from the Boston College store bundles? I have not looked into those. I actually am not sure how the pricing is. I feel like college stores just overprice things just because it's from Boston College, so they have that brand name so they can make it more expensive. So I would say no, but if I were to look into those, I would solely compare the price of the store bundles to Target and stuff like that. And just consider that you're probably gonna have the same bedding and whatever for the next 4 years. So get something that you like, and maybe you'll have it for more than 4 years. Maybe you'll live in a twin XL when you graduate college. Who knows? Maybe you'll have that bedding forever. So just keep that in mind. The last question is, how much clothes should/can freshmen bring? That's a good question. I honestly do not have an answer for that because I'm still figuring out how much I should bring. First semester, I didn't bring enough. I had to ask my mom to bring me more clothes. Second semester, I brought way too much and didn't wear a few pieces of clothing. But in the freshman dorms in Boston College, we have this weird wardrobe contraption that has space for hangers. It has space in the back where you can put folded clothes. And then we also have a dresser with four cubbies. So I personally only use three of the cubbies, and then the rest I use for food. But I also only use two of the hanging thingies. I brought a lot of clothes. I brought a lot of athletic clothes, way too much. And my definition of athletic clothes is just t-shirts that I got for free. I brought a bunch of shirts, probably bought like 30. Oh my goodness, I brought so many. I think I brought four leggings, three pairs of jean shorts, three pairs of athletic shorts, eight pairs of jean pants. I brought a lot of sweaters as well, and then socks and undergarments, obviously. Long story short, I have no idea how much clothes you should bring. People say to bring less clothes than you think you're gonna wear. I'd say at least bring a formal clothing. Just like think about what your life is gonna be like. Do you wanna go to parties? I don't know. Do you wanna bring more party clothes, or do you wanna bring more loungy clothes? Because I don't think people dress up that much in college. Like, some people go full out and they look super cool, but some people just dress like they're in high school. When I went to college, I realized how much clothes I have and how much clothes that I don't need. So I'm gonna be cleaning out my closet soon because I have way too much clothes and not enough days to wear them. Okay, so that ends this question answer session. I hope that I helped you guys a little bit. I know for some of the questions I didn't really have an answer, and I did ramble on in this video, but thank you guys so much again for your patience. If you guys have any more questions, remember to comment them down below. I'd love to answer any more questions that you have to the best of my ability. Yeah, that's basically it. Stay tuned for more videos, more Boston College videos, more summer videos. We'll see what I post. And I'll try to stick on my Tuesday, Friday schedule, but that has not been going well. But I'll try to stick to that. Like, subscribe, and all that jazz, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!